What's your name? Start with a C. Start with a G. Start with a Z. Nothing nasty now.
What's your name?
Spell it. H-I-J-K-A-L-M-A-N-O-A-B. That's how you spell it. Your name.
Okay, there I am. Alright. Sorry, I was having some technical difficulties there for a second. Nobody could hear me. And so I was trying to maybe get my audio working on the main scene, and it was not working, so that's why I was switching a lot. Anyway, hello everyone, it is time for another stream. Hello Murdoch, hello Moonlit, hello JJG, hello Big Mac. Alright. Hello, chat. Oh, go away. Yeah, again, I'm sorry about that at the beginning. I was just having some brief technical difficulties. We should be good now. I was having some technical difficulties before I started the stream, too, because my internet was, being all wonky, too. Hello, Moose T Wings. I want to say, is that two supposed to be a substitute for a Z, or is it just Moo? Or no, is it just M-O-O-2-T-Y Wings? Either way, welcome to the chat. I hope you enjoy your stay. It's like Moosty. Some people say Moody Wings. Hello, Tara. Thank you for the follow, Moosty. Hey, girly wolf pup. Hello, Willow. Cassie thinks your sleeps have been broken so much that I'd use your stream as the last thing to consume before going to Dreamland. It was nasty, but fix that shit for now. You're probably gonna relapse in like 4 days. Dude, I have been so tired lately, probably because of the caffeine withdrawal, that like I have been passing out in my chair for the past couple of days. And then I just wake up at like fucking 4 or 3 sometimes. I've been not doing so hot either. Yeah, just knocked out. Like, I collapse in my chair and pass out. It's not good for my chair nor my back. What do you think about ice Pikmin? Are those the white Pikmin? I mean, I just think Pikmin in general are cute. I don't know too much about Pikmin. I haven't played any of the Pikmin games. I think they all look a little scrunkly. I'm gonna be, like, fucking super irritable the next couple of days, I feel. Because not only have I been living on nothing but, like, oatmeal and soup and, like, other soft things for the past, like, at least week or two now at this point, but I'm also running on, like, no caffeine for at least the past week. So I'm hitting, like, the massive fucking caffeine withdrawal. And yesterday I ran out of hormones. And did you know that you can get addicted to your hormones? Hey, Mr. Plushie. I'm gonna be, like, super irritable. I'm gonna have, like, mad withdrawal symptoms from, like, 2 things. Double withdrawal, let's go. Y'all ever feel withdrawal from 2 things at once? I'm about to figure out what that feels like. Hey, Lily. Hey, Silvercloak. Oh, you've been here for a little bit. Oh, well. Yeah. I'm gonna be probably super fucking irritable the next couple of days. do. I can't wait until this bad health arc comes to a close. This has been fucking brutal. Everything about this has been fucking brutal. Gallstones for the past year. My teeth problems for the past, like, few months, for sure, especially. Now without hormones. I don't even know if they're going to, like, refill the hormones until I get my new doctor in August. And if that's the case, I'm going to be super irritable for the next week. And if that's the case, I don't know how much I'm going to be able to stream. Frankly. I'm going to be a fucking wreck if that's the case. I hope it's not the case. I hope I can get my refill at least within the next couple of days, but we'll see. Hey, Rhino. She's even healthy again. Unlimited power! No, I'll still be very limited. I'll just be able to eat again, which will be nice. I'll be able to get back at least some of my energy. Because one really big downside about all this is I have not had the energy to really work on very much. Like, I've got a handful of projects I'm working on, but, like, my progress on all of them have been nightmarishly slow. Hey, Slushy. She's eating Borger mukbang soon. Nah, I don't know when I'm gonna get my gallbladder fixed. There's nothing scheduled for that. Hey, villain. Twitter notice just now, we are take four out open. Yeah. A fucking sign. Give a real salsa lele vibes, yeah. The old salsa lele meme you made? Yeah. The one between, Little Essence and Willow, because the fucking course they'd be those three. Have you adjusted your diet lately, like going for more whole foods? Dude, I've been adjusting my diet all year. It's still miserable. Am I excited for any games this year? Most of the ones that I was excited for this year, I think have already come out. I don't know what else is being released this year, so... No, villain, the thing is, right? Before, I had, like, the problem with the gallbladder and stuff like that. A lot of my diet was consisting of beef, which I can no longer have. Eggs, which I can no longer have. And citrus. Which I can no longer have. Or which I shouldn't be having. So. Yeah. Game where you get to play as Daisy. Oh, is Wonder coming out this year? Okay, fair enough. I thought that was next year. Same goes for Super Mario RPG. I thought those were coming out next year. Fair enough. Well, then those, I guess. Yeah, I don't know what else is coming out offhand. No, I just, the things that... Winter's coming out in 3 months, fair enough. Is there any food that you like that you're allowed to eat? I mean... I was allowed to, I was allowed to eat salads, and I was eating that pretty fine, pretty much for the past year. But the problem is right now I can't have salads because it would fucking hurt to eat. Because I can't have anything crunchy because I have teeth problems. So, right now, I am stuck to eating salad and oatmeal. No, not salad. Soup and oatmeal. Soup and oatmeal are pretty much the only two things that I'm eating right now. That and anything else that might be soft. Like, I find that I can have chicken nuggets alright, I guess. Anything like maybe mac and cheese I can have. But for the most part, I'm stuck with, like, a very small handful of things that I can eat right now. And I am dying. Because it's not, this is, like, I am miserable. Can you go to the dentist? I'm scheduled for Friday. Presuming I don't get turned down again, because I was scheduled for last Friday. Actually, I think today's Saturday, right? No, today's Sunday. So, yeah, I was scheduled 2 Fridays ago then. But I was originally declined getting the root canals. So then I had to wait another 2 weeks. And so I'm scheduled for this Friday, presuming I don't get declined again. Do you have an O'Carly's near you? I don't know what that is, so probably not. How about rice? I could probably have that, but... I don't like rice. Texturally, it makes me gag. I'm not a big fan of it. I don't know, man. Right now, I'm fucking miserable. Like, I'm doing everything that I can. Doing everything that I can, I'm still fucking miserable. I'm just waiting for... waiting for Friday, I guess. Get potato soup from O'Charlie's. I've never heard of that place, so... And again, that's just soup. I've been having soup. Soup and oatmeal are like the two things that I have been eating, because I can't have very much else. No. I'm doing everything that I can, though. It's just not... It's not fun to be only able to eat, like, maybe 3 or 4 things. I'm miserable. Something like decent boiled eggs with mashed potatoes. Nope! Can't do eggs. Eggs is really bad for my, my stomach. The gallstones. I'm supposed to avoid eggs. Tuna? I mean, I could. Problem is I'd have to have just the tuna, like, dry. Like, from... You mean like canned tuna? I'd have to have that dry. And that's... disgusting. I don't know if you've ever had just the tuna out of a can, but it's not fun to eat. Like, it's just... it's so unpleasant. And I can't mix it with mayo because mayo is egg-based. How long have you only eaten soup and oatmeal so far? The past roughly 2 weeks. I'm miserable. High-fat diets are hard on those gallbladders. Tuna you might want to avoid. Oh, right, I didn't consider tuna has the tuna's fat content. You're right. I didn't think about that. So yeah, I might want to avoid tuna outright. No, that's a good point. Tuna has a chance of carrying mercury. Yeah, a lot of fish has mercury in it. I mean, fish would be pretty good for me overall, but maybe not currently with the gallstones. Cause yeah, I didn't consider the fat content in fish. What is wrong? Well, I just got through saying. Currently, like, I have been going through, I've been having gallstones for like the past year, so I've had to cut down on a lot of what I eat. And lately I've found out that I need 3 root canals because my teeth are just apparently that destroyed, and it actively hurts to eat anything crunchy right now. There are 2 spots in particular where my teeth are ridiculously chipped. I think it was like either last week or the week before, one of my fillings actually fell out. So, it had been the week before because I've been on soup and oatmeal the past 2 weeks. So, point is, I need 3 root canals. So I'm going to the dentist, hopefully, Friday. Hopefully I don't get declined again, like I did a couple weeks back, or a few weeks back now. I've had to cut down a lot of the fat content, and I've had to cut down anything crunchy. So right now, I am basically at old people food. Soup, oatmeal, and anything really mushy and soft. That is the extent of what I can eat right now. Hello, Ethereal. Yeah, I haven't gotten an operation on the gallstones yet, Mr. Plushy. That is the next step. But the problem is during trying to get everything fixed, I lost my doctor. My general care left the medical center that I went to commonly, so right now I don't have a doctor either to talk to about all this stuff. So... that is not gonna get changed until August 2nd, I think. So, right now, health-wise, I'm kind of up in the air. And it's not good. So I'll try to get everything fixed when I can. Are gallstones related to kidney stones? Not really. Sorta, kinda, not really. I don't know. Kidney stones would just put me in pain. Like, immense amount of pain. Gallstones only put me in pain if I eat the wrong things. Kidney stones are if you don't drink enough water, basically. Oh, it's surprising that I haven't hit those yet. Man, I don't know. I just want to be okay again. Well, as okay as I've been. Because to say that I was ever okay is kind of overplaying it. Hey, Valentine. Enjoy your lurk. when you watch on YouTube that's an expert. Dude, it's not gonna help me to watch like an expert talk about this stuff. The thing is, right? I need to talk to an actual doctor about this stuff. I need to get a doctor to help me get to a position where I can get these gallstones out of my, out of my system, right? Out of my body, out of the gallbladder. Like, I'm not here, like, we're not looking for, like, computer help. We're looking for body help. And that requires the medical field to actually sit down and fucking do something. Exactly, a YouTube tutorial on how to remove gallstones. It's like, that's not gonna help. We're not looking for, like, a YouTube tutorial here. No, I get it, villain. But it's... The problem right now is... Every time I talk about this, right? And this is the reason why I don't like bringing it up as frequently as I have been. And why I've been trying to, like, not talk about it as much. Because the minute that I bring it up, everyone, like, tries to start recommending me all these things. But I'm already doing everything that I can. I've already been doing these things because I've had these gallstones for a year. I've been doing everything I can to try to keep myself from not destroying myself. It's just a matter of waiting for the healthcare system to give a shit now. See, I understand the want to help, it's just... I'm not in a position where anything else can really be done other than just wait. And this isn't just go for villain either, this goes for pretty much everyone. Like, I appreciate the want to help, guys, I really do. But it's just... I'm kind of at a point where, like, the thing that I need is more immediate. It's more finalized, more physical. So. It's why I've been trying to avoid talking about it as much as I have been. About that, what the fuck do kids like math? Dude, I don't know. To Rick and Morty anime? Yeah, I don't understand why. Isn't Rick and Morty, like, still around? Oh, yeah, no, apparently there's going to be a Rick and Morty anime, and I don't understand why. Like, that was confirmed. It's just Rick and Morty, yeah. Which is why I'm like, isn't Rick and Morty still around? This is like... You know what this is like? This is like, was it The Last of Us Part 2 remaster for PS5? You know, the same system that The Last of Us Part 2 is on? The same fucking the same same idea, same general gist. Yeah, the Harley Quinn anime, that's one thing. Rick and Morty, but again, but this time it's an anime. It's like it's like The Last of Us Part 2 being remade for the same system that it was on originally. When are we getting AU Doodles the anime? Probably never. Dude, I would like my series to be animated. I don't ever see it getting to that point. You caught up on the Doodleverse story? Fair enough. At least Suicide Squad Isekai is gonna be a new plot, yeah. Oh, Bimbo Tones. Alright. You need to see Little Fuck shit up on the big screen. Dude, I think it would be really cool to see my series be animated. I don't ever see it happening though. Mainly because I do everything on my own for this, and there's not like an easy way for me to like animate everything. I gotta have to do it all by hand, and I don't want to do that. It's fine if it's not animated, as long as it's a good story, which it is fine. And I'm not a writer, right? This was like my first time writing anything remotely serious. Are we ever getting Elder Scrolls 6? Skyrim is on like 8 consoles. I mean, we got the teaser, so we know it's happening. It's just a matter of when. You didn't even always use stills in the beginning? Yeah. That's actually gonna kind of make a return. Well, yeah. Did you make any more stories? And if so, what's your most recent one? I'd like to watch it. The AU Doodle story is pretty much the only one that I've got. The only other story that lasted as long as this one has was my old Doodle Tones 2 comic back when I was in high school. But there's not very many places to watch that. Read that, because it's a comic, it's not an actual series. So, that's the only other thing I have. So, shrug. Todd was all. Susie, I think we have another believer. Uh-oh. God. But yeah, this is the the Doodleverse story is like all I've got, frankly. I don't have any other stories yet. Keyword, yet. I am kind of working on the world of Terradale, and that might be something at some point. But, it's not finished. Or it's not, well, I say it's not finished. It's not even started yet. Was it you that retweeted the Tom and Jerry gacha game? I don't remember that, if I had. That's very interesting, if I did. Because I don't remember it. Have you seen Pig? You're gonna have to be a bit more specific, because it seems pretty vague. What is... Nick Cage movie about him getting his truffle pig back? No. I have no idea what that is. No, I've not. Thank you. Thank you for the follow, Tendo the Seal. Welcome to the chat. I hope you enjoy your stay. Been a fan on YouTube for a while. Glad to finally catch a stream. Fair enough. I'm just doing more of the sprite work for the move of the little series that I do, the little story that I'm doing, because I know a lot of people on my main channel don't care. So I'm moving it over to another channel. But that means that I need to do a bunch of redesigning and shit. Which channel, because you're invested? The channel's not up yet, because I haven't gotten to the part where I'm posting things yet. But I'll make an announcement on my main channel about it. You get the concern of someone getting into making Connected Store YouTube content yourself? Yeah, well, I've been doing mine since 2017, and I know not too many people care. I can't say that nobody cares, because obviously that's not true. You have people like Pink Robot and Aaron Tempest who have made videos about my story. You know, I can't say that nobody cares. But I am becoming more and more aware to the fact that not too many people do. Like, they're there for the commentary, not there for the story. So I'm going to move it from the main channel to another channel and then just start releasing commentaries again like normal. Without any of the lore attached to it. You literally only watch for the story? Well, then the new channel will probably be more for you then. Might be more beneficial for the story since it'll be more linear. Maybe. But yeah, I don't know. I understand that the story is not what people watch my content for. So, shrug. It's gotten to the point where it's like, it's just kind of in the way. And I know it is for people. So I'm not gonna... I'm not gonna force people to watch it if they don't want to. And those who do want to pay attention to the story, or those who are invested in the story, well, they'll have another channel where I can then just do the lore, and I don't have to worry about having commentary material. So I can just continue the lore on a much, you know, much quicker pace, possibly, too. So, you know, you got that going for it. So. I don't know. I like this story and I don't want to just see it go to waste. Why did you want to make the lore? Because I was told that it would be impossible to do, like, a serious lore attached to commentaries, and I took that as a challenge. But it's just kind of turned into something that I really like doing. But when nobody cares, I mean, what do I do, right? Well, next to nobody cares. What do I do at that point, right? It's kind of a little demotivating to see people not want to interact with the story. Like, there are people who ask what the story is about, and I'm just sitting here like, dude, my channel, like, there is a place where you can get caught up on it that's like attached to my main channel. There's no reason to not know certain things about the story. The lore is a nice open to the videos, an hors d'oeuvre, if you will. Yeah, but everyone skips it anyway. It's putting something you're passionate about on its own little island so you can nurture it and watch it grow? Yeah, kinda. Skip it, they're cringe. Well, again, that's kind of the problem. Like, the thing is I know a lot of people, like a good chunk of my audience does not care for it. So I'll put in the extra effort to move it over to another channel, to reintroduce it, to like maybe polish it up a bit. And those who do care can watch it. Those who don't, they don't have to worry about it. I can also use this time to do things with my lore that I didn't do before that I'm a little regretful about. Such as properly introducing all of the AU doodles to the story. Because that's something that I didn't really do back in the original iteration. I can the bit of extra things that I originally had to take out for lack of time or a bad UI. So, I don't know. I can use this time to, like, I guess, make the doodle cut. You know how there's the Snyder cut? The doodle cut? I can use this time to do that. Spider-Verse intro? Not too far off. I did think that was a pretty cool idea, and I figure I could probably do something with that. I mean, that wasn't the original idea, but I have thought about it since. And that does seem like a pretty good way of introducing all of the characters. Another flaw that I'm seeing in the story is for the fact that all the kept doodle alts are supposed to have a trait that makes them useful. They're not seen as a lot or utilized a lot in the story. There's a bit more to it than that. But yeah, there's a lot of AU doodles that take a backseat to the actual story itself. Kind of by design, but also I understand why some people would have a problem with that. So Let's take this from the top one more time. My name is Doodle Tones. Yeah, basically. Oh, whoops! Y'all still have bimbo tones. At least for another 5 minutes. Repeat 2.5 dozen times. Yeah. Well, as I said, I would have like different ways of starting it and stuff like that, but the idea of like creating ways of introducing the characters better, I definitely want to do, because I didn't do it that well initially, and I kind of regret that because there's a lot of fun little tidbits of the characters that nobody pays attention to. Or maybe there's just, like, a story that... Or a story about the characters that, like, nobody knows. Doodle Cut's 8 hours would make John Wheaton cry. Nah, I don't think it's gonna be that long. Like, the original story's, like, an hour. So, I mean... like, it's about a movie length. But again, I do regret not introducing all of them. All of them needed a proper introduction, and they didn't get it. Thank you. You don't think there's sound? Wait, what do you mean there's no sound? Sound should, like, the music should be the only thing you guys are hearing right now. Have you guys not been able to hear the music? Cause it's... Have you guys not been able to hear the music? Okay. The character seemed like it was speaking. Oh, it was probably air then. Also, you guys no longer should have bimbo tones. It has been 30 minutes. Yeah, basically. We got the DR music. Yeah, yeah. Oh, Danganronpa's got some bops. I don't know what to tell ya. Playing Ring Code? Not yet. I'd like to, though. I actually got a few things on my backlog that I would like to play, but I'm not gonna get to playing them until I'm done with these sprites. Like, I've got, Pokemon Black on the backlog. I'm gonna try Cloud Punk again once all this is done. We'll try to get back into hi-fi. That Bijou Mike is a name I haven't heard since fucking Hello Neighbor. Wow. But yeah. I need to get around to playing Hi-Fi. I'm gonna play Cloud Punk. I'm gonna play Pokemon Black. And then I'll have to find two more games. And I've got quite a bit of a backlog, so I could probably find something. Maybe something that I've quit and never came back to. Possibly. Or maybe something that I've wanted to play but haven't gotten around to because of these sprites. I'm sure there's something or another. Yeah, Raincoat is something that I could probably pick up at some point. I think it'd be nice. What else is on my Steam list that I haven't played in a while? Oh yeah, I do want to get around to playing, oh, what was it? Yeah, you want those games, right? So here you go, now let's see you clear them. I want to get around to playing that at some point. Just because I think that'd be silly. Could probably do Bioshock Infinite, because I never did get around to finishing, that game on stream. Because I could only play it a little bit, but it ran at, like, a fucking snail's pace. Because I played 1 and 2 on stream, and I have played and finished Infinite, but I didn't do it on stream. So I want to do that at some point, too. So I might pick back up, Infinite. But yeah. I might pick up, yeah, you want those games, right? So here you go, now let's see you clear them. Which, by the way, a real title to a game. It is, I am not making the name up. It is, yeah, you want those games, right? So here you go, now let's see you clear them. I bought this, like, a couple days ago. I am not kidding. This is what it is called. It's got a very similar, similar vibe to, sometimes to deal with the difficulty of being alive, I need to believe that there's a possibility that life is not real. It's got a very similar vibe to this. Which is also a real title to a real game that actually exists. Looks like a goofy but great game. What? Sometimes deal with the possibility of... Or no. Sometimes deal with life, I need to believe the possibility that life is not real. It's a very existential game. But yeah, you want those games right. Well, here you go. Let's see you clear them. Is a response to all of those mobile game ads. Katamari Deluxe devs made it. Oh, the... Yeah, you want those games? Is this Katamari? Oh yeah, it was. And Klonoa. That's kinda cool, actually. I like that. Katamari Damacy is the game that surpasses all games. Dude, Katamari is so fun. At least the first one was. I haven't played any of the others past that, but like, I don't imagine they'd be too different. Katamari seems like one of those games that you can't really fuck up, you know? As soon as you hear la 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 la, you know you're in for a good time. Yeah. Well, there's another game that's very that has like a very similar soundtrack to it. At least a similar vibe. Do I have it on my... Yeah. So listen to this fucking soundtrack. Oh, this isn't the song that I'm thinking it is. So I guess I don't have the other one then. Oh well. I wish I had the other one, because the other one is very Katamari Damacy sounding. This one isn't quite that one. I thought it was. It is not. And that seems to be the only one that I have of this game, so... Unfortunately, this is all I got. I'll have to go in and find the other song that I'm thinking of. No, RoboRabbits is a fucking insane game. That's something else maybe I should play on stream one day. So that way you guys can get all of your Doodles of Sapphic jokes out of the way. Get them out of your system. Because the RoboRabbits is something that I grew up playing. Thank you for the follow, Marshmallow Dross. Okay. I found the one that I'm thinking about. Hold on. Let me turn on desktop audio here. It's very Katamari. That was the one that I was thinking of. That's the one I thought I had. I do not have that, but that I will after this stream is done. I will download the rest of the soundtrack after this stream. Absolutely. Actually, you know what? Let's play the rest of this. Wait, is he still out for 3 in the future? Yeah, of course. I know more or less what it would look like for each of the seasons. Eventually I will, absolutely. Seeing it too loud? Fair enough. I'll turn it down a bit. But yeah, I do plan on doing seasonal outfits for you in the future. That's the end of that one. Okay. Well, back to the Skullgirls OST then. Skullgirls remind me a bit of Happy End, Japanese folk band from the 70s. I believe ya. It probably is inspired. I wouldn't be surprised. So how far in are we? To what, the stream or the sprites? You're gonna have to be more specific. Both. Well, stream, we've got like 20 more minutes left. The sprites, well, we're on Yule, so we're like 2 from done. Because after Yule, it's gonna be Z. But Z's got like 4 outfits to do, so... Or 4 sprite sets to do. So that one's gonna take me a little bit longer. Yeah! So I got like 4 more sprite sets to do, all for Z. Means you can finally end up having figuring out how to end season one. Oh no, I've still got a ways before I completely redo season one, because I got a bunch of cutscenes and stuff to make too. Yeah, the story's got a bit of ways before we're done. Is Yule canonically around that often? I mean, she's around as much as she needs to be. Again, the reason that you don't see a lot of the characters is because, I mean, again, partly by design, some of them just are not important to story one. At least not as much as, like, some other characters. They will have their time in the spotlight in, like, story 2 and so on, but... Have you checked the horror SMP yet? No, I've not joined the horror SMP. I don't plan to. Shame she got put in the box. Yeah, again, some of the AU doodles just are not important to story 1. They'll be important later. Probably. Like, they'll have their time to shine eventually. I mean, Yule is a good example of that. Yule is gonna be super important for story 2. UV is gonna be super important for story 2. Well, technically, is it really story 2 or is it like story 6 or 7? I guess that's gonna be really the question. Like, how am I going to do story 2? Because story 2 gets split off into, like, 6 different stories. 7 different stories. Something along those lines. So story 2 is more like stories 2 through 8. So... It's, Yeah. So Yule will have her time to shine, at least. Even if it takes 7 stories to do it. This is spoilers? Is it? Because I've talked about this before. I've talked about it before that, like, each of the AU doodles are getting split off into, like, different stories and stuff like that. And they will have their time to shine. Like, the whole point of story 2 is so more people can see the other AU doodles. And be introduced to maybe some Dutopia lore. Like, that's kind of the whole point of doing story 2. Is there entropy? Can't believe you're already drawing, Gil. You're almost done. Well, almost done with the sprites. That doesn't mean that I'm almost done entirely. Still got a bit of ways to go, because I've got cutscenes to do and stuff like that. But yeah, we're almost done with the sprites, which is a good chunk of what I need to do. Okay, so far we have tried 1, reinstalling Minecraft from the base version with Forge and without mods. It loads, but load anything and it crashes. Maybe it's something to do with what's in the mod pack. Like, do you know what you guys are trying to add? Is there, like, conflicting mods and stuff like that? Do the detailed crash log, figure out which things were both in and not in the mod pack. Okay. Bit more fucky than that? Oh boy. It's throwing out Java errors. Have you looked up any of the Java errors? Plunder took at least half an hour. Yeah, have you guys looked through, or like, have you guys looked at the error log? All those things you can get fixed from those. I was running an older version of Java, updated it. Got a bit farther, then crashed. That makes me worried for season 2. Cause Mally wants to add more mods to season 2. Moonlit just casually talking over, or taking over chat. Yeah, Moonlit does that sometimes. Just let them get it out of their system, then you guys can use the chat again. It's their turn to use the chat. Yeah, basically. It's... Again, it's... just something that Moonlit tends to do. It's just kind of a let them get it out of their system, and then they'll calm down. So... joining into a voice call was weird. God, remember when I was called Mama Doodle? That was fun, I guess. Shrug. We laughed at Digital Ty because they said that. It was, well, I mean, it wasn't Ty that came up with the meme. It was Scarlet and Silver, and then it became like a little bit of a meme at the time. And then that's why Ty worded it that way. When was this? 2016, 2017. Yeah, it was Silver and Scarlet who started it. And then it became a brief little SCC meme. It was a decade ago. Not quite there yet. Give it another 3 years. We're not that old yet. Later, Zerenthropy. 3 more years. Fuck. Yeah. Irvine just chilling out, yeah. Apparently you guys got a new Herobrine mod. Cause the other one was kind of a nuisance. I.e. no chicken horde if it's done right. Dude, I remember the old Herobrine mod where you would just build like traps and stuff all around your world. I actually didn't mind that version of the Herobrine mod. That version was aight. He still does? Oh, okay. The Herobrine mod that I remember, he would build little structures around, some of them were trapped. He would talk to you through chat sometimes. He would teleport around, and if he saw you during, I think, night hours specifically, he would try to attack you, and he was, like, decked out sometimes. He does, like, a fuck ton of damage. That's all I remember him doing back then, but you had to summon him with, like, a bunch of little, netherite blocks, and then, like, one thing of gold, or something like that. Or maybe it was, like, a gold statue, something along those lines. You had to, like, light, I think netherrack or something on fire, and it summoned him, so you actually had to, like, summon him in order for him to be active. That's the mod that I remember. It's kind of like having a little friend on your single player world. It's Some of my quest line starts as soon as you get a stone pickaxe or something. Huh. Well. Yeah, he was like a little friend that you just had on this on the world with you that would sometimes turn angry and try to kill you. So you know, like a friend on a Minecraft server. Yeah, he wasn't really scary to me. I mean, he was never really scary to me because I was there when the fucking lore was created. I was there when the fucking Iron Door got misinterpreted as a fucking character. So, he's never really been scary to me. But, remember having bought Sims 4 and trying to download hairs and clothing to try to put them into the game and it never worked? Herobrine versus Doodlebob. That sounds like an epic rap battle thing. Fucking fresh you get on that. I think you would like the war mod if only because of the depraved stuff Melly put in. I don't tend to like horror. The only reason I wouldn't mind Herobrine is just on the basis of, again, I know the story behind him. I know he's not that harmful. He's just like a little nuisance running around that would occasionally try to kill you. Anyway. We've been going for about 2 hours. So I'm gonna go ahead and call that a stream. Nice thing about murder houses, they have lore and quest stuff. Fair enough. Already scared by Wobbly Enderman? Yeah, I hated that. Anyway. Later, chat!